Hi everybody, thank you for asking about the heddle loom. Today we make the video to explain how we make it with a minimum of tools. Let's get started. First about the tools. I used this good saw and the jigsaw, which is not shown here. And you will need those chisels in different sizes, like 10 millimeter and 5 millimeter. This chisel is very useful to make this square hole in here. This is an upcycled stick and is now in use for the frame of the heddle loom. Actually, you can take any wood you can find, just make sure it is strong enough. Our stick here we use is around about 2.5 to 3 centimeters thick. This is the warp beam, made out of a broomstick. You can find it in any bigger supermarket. On this thin but strong stick, you tie the yarn later on. The size here is about 2 centimeters wide and 1 centimeter thick. This one here is for sure strong enough. This part will hold the heddle later. The board I used was 1.5 centimeters thick. I cut them out of a board on which I make a drawing before. The picture will show you more clearly the position of the hooks. The size of the hooks, of course, depending on the size of the heddle it shall hold. The gears are a special topic. They need a closer look on. You need two gears of opposite direction. I constructed them by preparing a template on cardboard first. All I needed was this pair of compasses and the ruler. This was my template I used before to make those gears. How you will do is, you take the template, put it on the board you like to use, draw around the corners and later again with the pair of compasses. Now you cut out the round disc with the drawing of the gear on it. On this picture you can see how to make the template step by step. Now you cut out the corners of your disc. You may also thinking about using a bigger machine for cutting, but I strongly recommend a hand tool that is easy to control. On the right you can see an old picture of the construction of this gear. Let's talk about the other side. You can see my cuttings I made this way were a tiny little bit too deep, but without any negative effect for operating. In the middle I made a square hole, round about 1 centimeter deep. The opposite part of the square hole is on the warp beam. You make first your drawing on the stick, cut a square out, and then use this square as a template to make the hole. Take care to keep always the right position of the square when making the hole. Numbers are very helpful. It fits and it cannot move. And with a screw we let the gear become one with the warp beam. The other side get the 6-corner wheel. As you can see, it's the same kind of construction as for the gears. It is mainly helping you to handle the warp beam. Again, you first draw the square, cut it out, use the square as a template, draw around, and then make the hole with your chisel. Step by step, this may take a while. Here you can see how you easily make a template for the six corner wheels. Those body parts I cut out of one big board that was 1.5 cm thick. This is the stick to stop the gear later. I make one length of the body out of two parts. If you can, I recommend make the length of the body out of one piece. Another square stick for the construction of the frame. And here, the second warp beam, same like on the opposite side. On this picture you can see more clearly the construction of the body. And here again a picture for the other sticks you will need. The heddles. They might be not perfect, but they are perfectly working. Important here is that one stick of the heddle is longer than the other one. We used sandpaper to bring the thin sticks in this condition. The body part that hold later your heddle need to have the right size. The hooks need to be in the right position. Take care when gluing together to use the spacers in the right way, to not have those big gaps as this heddle have. In the long, bigger frame stick I cut a groove on both sides. Before you glue the smaller sticks in, use sandpaper to make sure your wood cannot catch the yarn. Because you have to cut out a lot of the smaller sticks, it's better to build something up to make the work easier. Out of this material I made the smaller sticks. And this little tool is helping me. The gap you can see shows you the size of the small stripes that will later coming out. This is the way of the saw that will cut the stripes all with the same size. You first put the material you want to cut in. And then bring the saw in the right position. I better should have used a vise for my tool. And this is the stick. Here you can see a finished and an unfinished one. You only need now sandpaper and a screwdriver. Of course you should use a drill on top. And then you have this hole. It's not perfect but working. For more detailed information about the size you can take a look on this picture. And now let's building up.
Eins. Ja, das kommt schon mal hier. Das kommt hier. Das ist dann 4, 5. Das ist 6. Hier hin. Das kommt hier hin. Okay, wir brauchen, das ist noch nicht, das ist später, das ist 8. Das ist 4, das ist okay, das ist 2, 3, 4, dann ist das 4. Ah, okay, das kommt auch hier runter. Ja, 1 und 8. So, I make markings anyway, so here's the 7, here's the 7, here's the 5, here's the 5. Und dasselbe, the same on the other side. 8, 8 und 6 und 6. Genau, so, dann nehmen wir uns mal. So, then we take the screwdriver. First one. Coming to the next one. First part is prepared. So, now coming to the more interesting part is, I guess, this one. So, then we connect this ones. Better now. So. And finish. Same other side. We are coming to the second part. So, again, same procedure. So, the second part, reconnecting now. So. So, and the last finger here, or the nearly last finger. So, one, two to two.
As I mentioned before, I strongly recommend to make the length of the body out of one piece. We decided to make two pieces because we thought it would be easier to transport. And that is true, but we found out actually we never transported it so much. It has only negative effects that it easier can bending when you have the yarn in. So the next machine I will build up, the length of the body will be made out of one piece, I think. The second thing on this machine was that this one was too small. The perfect position for the heddle was on top instead on the higher hook. In the shown pictures, I fixed this problem already. Thanks for watching. I hope the video could explain everything clear enough. If you have any question, we would like to answer them. See you next video. Bye bye.